Hey, would you rather? I'm not as ready as I thought I was. Would you rather kill Adolf Hitler or kill the island boys? Roll it!
Fuck you. You're here for rock bottom.
This one feels like rock bottom.
I'm completely lost. Man, when you press record, I freeze up.
You ever see that movie that that's from?
No.
It's Team America World Police. It's from the guys that created South Park. They made that little like puppet movie.
What?
It's really funny.
I only thought they made basketball.
No, they made that. That's what that's from. It's like, I'm completely lost. I'm at rock bottom. He's in the bar.
That's Soap's favorite movie is basketball.
Basketball's really funny. It's one of those.
I don't know if I've ever seen it.
Oh, it's...
What was my stupid fucking thing?
Would you rather kill Adolf Hitler or the island boys? Island boys!
I'm just a motherfucking island boy. I'm gonna keep a fucking island
boy. I don't know what they
boy.
Say. What do they say?
But if it be fucking 1v1, homie better keep it going.
Did you see the...
I'm a fucking glow like a staring at the sun.
They, you looked up the lyrics. They...
No.
They...
Cliff notes.
They did a live show. And it was like really not that cool.
God, they look so like they just don't look correctly built. Like God fucked it up or something.
What? Their parents are there. Like,
their dad's dead.
Good, dude. I'm sure he's fucking glad.
Oh, man.
I'm sure he's fucking like, thank God.
They're island boys. I'm a heaven boy. I'm out of here. My kids are stupid.
Thank God.
My kids are dumb. I'm out.
Can you imagine having twins and then both of them fuck up?
Dude, I saw a crate and it's...
I'd rather kill the island boys. I don't think what Hitler did was that bad. Go ahead.
Yeah, I don't want to... That's like the butterfly effect, you know? Everything's okay right now. So
I'm not even laughing.
That's Mason. I'm Mark. What was I saying? Oh. I said oh like I knew what I was saying. What were we just talking about?
The island boys'
dad killed himself because he hates their kids.
Imagine having two kids, two twins.
Okay, no. This is what I was going to say. And I always want to talk about something on this podcast that actually isn't funny.
Mm-hmm. That can totally be a thing.
But I kind of laugh about it.
Okay.
There's a video of him like getting hit by his girlfriend and he's like crying and stuff. And it's like so... I don't know what's real anymore.
The internet kind of construes what's real and what's not real. I have no idea.
It looks like he was getting his fucking ass beat.
Well, if he's getting hit, you can be like, "Oh, that was a hit."
It didn't. I don't know the context of it. She started like beating the shit out of him,
mm-hmm.
and then in the video, she's like, "Look at my lip. Look what you did to my." I don't know if he hit her first.
She hits herself, and she's like, "Look at my lip."
Yo, she's not there. She did low key, but again, I don't know what he did. Judging by my assumed IQ. Of that I'm giving this man, I assume he didn't do anything great, and she started beating the shit out of him. But he's, like, crying. He's like, look, oh, my hair. And I was like, ah, man, I want to laugh at you, buddy, but I actually do feel kind of bad for you.
Gosh.
She's on, like, Instagram Live, like, thotting it up while she's beating the fuck out of his, like, Minecraft torch fucking head.
What? Dude, for real. They fucking ran out of torches. They're out of wood. I don't know what inspired them for that look. I don't know if they both came out of the room and they both looked like that. And they're like, no way. Oh, sick. And they're like the Spider-Man meme.
They look like they like took a bunch of quarters to the meat market and got a bunch of those crank tattoos. Started putting it all around their face. Like,
the fucking ones that are right around their neck that are, I think they're around their chest. And then it's like the dripping, but one of them has green drip and then one of them has the red drip.
Really?
That is the worst.
It's kind of cool.
Shut up. You would like
that. I like that the dude has like an eagle in between his fucking eyebrows.
Would you?
Oh my God. He should have connected him. How sick would it be? An eagle tattoo in the middle of your fucking eyebrows, but your eyebrows are the wings.
That'd be sick. You got sweet eyebrows, though.
I have good eyebrows?
You got to have sweet eyebrows to do that.
Oh, you have to have sweet eyebrows.
You were like, I have sweet eyebrows?
Yeah, thanks.
Oh, thanks.
Thanks. Well, I pluck them.
I get them threaded.
Threaded.
That's a weird thing, too. That's not real. Threading your eyebrows?
Yeah, it doesn't seem real.
Okay, someone's doing some sewing circles on your face. It doesn't seem like it would do anything.
I was going to, remember when I was like, by the way, I texted you, by the way, I'm actually almost to your house.
Mm-hmm.
I was going to try to prank you guys, but I didn't do it.
What was the prank going to be?
Because I wasn't in a good mood until I got here.
Well, that's good that you're in a good mood now.
I'm barely, but
well, at least I changed it a little bit.
You didn't.
Almost I think you more or less forgot about whatever you're going through.
Yeah, and now I'm remembering. I was just going to try to scare you. I was going to bang on that big window, but then I was like, ah,
then you put your hand through it, and then
I see my truck.
That's the whole thing.
Yeah, they're my
I hear
big
your truck from
headlights.
Down the block. Yeah, you understand dude. That? It sounds like a fucking tank coming down the blah, 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 blah.
I roll over your garage.
Somebody driving a boat down the fucking road.
I was going to bang on the glass and prank you, but I didn't.
Yeah, you won't be able to pull that off unless you like to drive a Prius up to my house or something.
What's your sickest prank ever?
My sickest prank I've ever done? Gosh. I've scared Michaela sometime, and they're not like... It's
scared
not like,
the tits off her.
It's not like a crazy prank, but...
Nah, it sucks.
The fucking greatest prank you pulled, I think, was making your friend eat the hot chip.
Oh,
and it was on TikTok.
Yeah.
It was on TikTok, dude. Explain it, because the TikTok doesn't do it justice, because you only get so many
seconds. It's too tough. It was tough to try to film it without having a camera in his face.
Yeah.
You know what I fucking hate real quick?
Boy,
I fucking hate. Put a pin in that.
Okay.
Put that on the back burner. I poisoned my friend and we almost had to take him to the hospital out of my amusement. I fucking hate when I'm watching like Facebook videos or like, and they're staged. Like, the person's, like, doing the dishes, and then there's a fucking person behind them and a cameraman, and they're, like, putting their finger to their mouth, like, shh, I'll be quiet, like, I'm gonna do this crazy
yeah.
thing. I'm like, this is so fucking staged.
And it sucks.
This is so staged. I hope something goes terribly wrong. I hope you slip and break your fucking ankle. Oh, my God, dude, I fucking hate it. And I watch them still. I still watch them.
You know what I watch, and it sucks, is those five-minute craft videos. That they're like, what the fuck? Like, they're putting, like, ramen in fucking tables and sanding it down and then painting over it. And
oh, the way they, like, hide stuff?
No, yeah, that. But then there's, like, these, like, five-minute, it's, like, it's called five-minute crafts. And it's not even crafts. It's just, like, them fixing shit in the weirdest ways possible. And, like, they just do dumb shit, like, fixing these tables and stuff. They put, like, spray foam on these tables, sand it down, color it, like, red. So no one can see that they obviously put, like, foam as the corner of a table. It's just fucking stupid. And I watched the whole 15-minute video, and then I'm done, and I'm like, what did I fucking gain out of that?
Dude, I will watch 12-minute fucking videos of someone, like, trying to wrestle a fish out of the fucking water. And I'm like, God, I just got to see what this stupid fucking fish looks like. And I hate it. I don't fish. I don't even like fish.
You don't want to skip to the end because you're scared you're going to lose some lore in the middle.
I don't know what's happening. I need the character development. I don't want to miss the peaks and valleys.
Yeah.
I'm like, fuck, dude. Just pull
the
fucking fish out.
Goes.
Oh, my God. And then another one. Sorry, not to fucking harp on this. Another one was this guy. This fucking hillbilly Cabela couple, and I'm fucking sick of them too. All right, quit getting matching Carhartt fucking hoodies. All right,
you just bought your dog one, but go ahead.
I bought him a Carhartt coat. He's a hard-working dog.
It doesn't fit him, but go
yes,
ahead.
It does.
It doesn't make him warm.
Sure, it does.
Yeah,
it's rated
back.
A three. It's rated a three on the fucking warmth scale.
Yeah, three
out of five.
As a stage of hypothermia is going to get when he fucking goes outside of that.
What are you talking about?
It just didn't look like he fit him. He has enough fur. He's like a fucking...
Well, yeah, he's got enough fur.
Shit.
I got it because it looks cute on him.
Why are the Australian shepherds, if they have long-ass fur like that, they think they'd be bred to have, like, short fur. It's hot as fuck over there.
They're
all the time.
Not to get into this, but they're actually not from Australia. Australian
so,
shepherds.
Why do they call them that?
They are from here, but they have like a little bit of like cattle dog in them or something.
Yeah, I can see that.
Australian cattle dog, but I think they originally came here. Maybe,
you did your research.
I'm actually a certified stupid person. I have a certificate with my name on it from Michigan. So don't listen to anything I'm saying, but I'm pretty positive they came here. Maybe they I'm going to kill myself. I think they were here to be a rodeo dog in like
that makes
the circus.
Sense. I've seen those kind of like a circus dog.
Yeah. I mean, not my Doofy Doofy, but...
Yeah, not Boofy Goofy Doofy Woofy.
Yeah, he's just a good little boy.
But why don't you bring him over?
I want to and play with Benny, but I don't want him to suck. And then I get distracted.
They both...
And,
no, I mean...
And Michaela's here, but her tits are all sore, and I'm not trying to get... So I literally almost... today was almost a day I brought Doofy my Juvy to Boofy Doofy, and I didn't.
You definitely should bring him. There's no fucking reason not to. They wear themselves out, and he won't, like... chew up everything in your house. Is he still doing that? Is he still being a fucking asshole?
No, we do.
Dude, I came over and he literally, it was when Nathan had all his drums there, and it like literally came over and it looked like a wood chipper went through your house.
He was chewing up Nathan's drumsticks for a second. Like, he was teething.
What
bro. The fuck?
Yeah, okay. What is he, a fucking baby?
He's a beaver. What was I saying?
Keep growing.
Okay. These fucking Frank's Great Outdoors couples, dude. And then I was watching.
Just want a gift certificate to that.
God damn. I was watching this fucking sirloin steak looking fucking guy open up his present from this girl. And she's recording him. And she's like, open it. He's like, why are you recording me? Staged. And I waited 4 minutes for this fucking brute to open this fucking box just to see he got a stupid fucking crossbow. Or a fucking compound
bow.
You fit a crossbow
in a box?
No, it was like a bow, a dumbass bow to shoot a dumbass deer.
Sweet.
He's like, well, he started crying. I'm like, oh my God.
Yeah, wait, was that your dad's bow and he's dead? Or what?
Fuck you.
Jesus Christ.
Oh my Lord. I was so mad. I literally. Can I make a confession?
Yeah. You bought a crossbow?
I love compound arrows and bows. No, I don't know anything.
They're cool to
fuck. I don't know anything about them. I think they're dumb. I think it's stupid.
Anything that I make fun of. And then I'm such a hypocrite when it comes to stuff that I make fun of because I'm like, oh, you got guns, shooting guns, bang, 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 bang. And then I'm like, and then someone's going to come up to me like, hey, you want to go shoot guns? And I'm like, yes, I want to go shoot guns.
I would love to shoot guns. I do love shooting guns.
I want to go do bop, 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 bop.
Dude, that's because like fucking people ruin it. Now I think of guns, I just think of like dumbasses. But when me and my friends are like, let's grab our fucking blickies and go shoot them outside. I'm like, oh, sweet.
I don't want
to go
like,
point
them
at cats and fuck. And I'm like, yes.
And then I'm on my, you know, I'm trying, you know, if I go out to the bar, which is a very rare occasion, and as of lately, it's not because I'm depressed. So Mark goes a lot. And then like guys try to come up and they're like, yeah, I've got this Mossberg 500,000 Mossberg. I'm like, I don't even know. And they're like, and they just talk about it. I'm like, I don't know what you're talking about, dude. And I'm like, yeah, that sounds good. Yeah, I'm like shaking my head. And obviously,
does it send a bullet through your head?
Yeah. Can it kill me right now, like, to get me out of this conversation?
If you put it to
you
my temple
it?
And you pull the trigger, and I'm gone, right? I go bye-bye.
Can you Kurt Cobain my ass right now so I don't have to fucking talk to you anymore? You ignorant ass. I'm losing brain cells.
Honestly,
sorry.
Though, on the other side of that, like the worst side of like, that's like the extreme of one side of the general population right now, and then the other side is just obsessed with these stupid fucking vape sticks and breeze sticks.
No.
And God, you stupid fucks, you're worried about like what wattage it pulls, like you're smoking a vacuum.
This isn't that
shit is
I,
stupid.
To be
fuck
fair
it. You look dumb. It looks like you're smoking a USB fucking port. And
okay, are you done?
Oh, now what? We just harsh the mellows of gun owners, and now I can't.
Now I'm mad.
I can't fuck around with.
Okay.
To
be fair, I've been in every single part
Nick
of
stick
that.
Owners.
I've been every single part of that. You had a thing against beer. You tried beer. Now it's the best thing in your fucking life. Okay, it's great.
It is not great.
You ever tried fucking getting a Nick buzz? It's like you're on heroin, dude. The first time, you're fucking your head gets light. You're fucking pins and needles in your fingers. Maybe I'm doing something else, but the first time I got a real Nick buzz was I stole a dip of my dad's chew when I was like 14.
That's fair.
And I was like gaming. I was gaming in my PS3 back in those days. And I went and my dad was gone. I was like, oh, I was a baseball player. That's like baseball, like
what you do.
Culture.
We've seen Sandlot.
Yeah.
You got the big league
it's
chew.
It's culture, dude.
No, chaw.
And they did Red Man that comes in the big league chew pouches. But anyway, I go and I snap open his thing. I've seen him do it 1,000 times. So I do the thing that everybody does where they do.
Gave it two thwaps.
They thwap it and they pack it. And it hurt my finger real bad.
And you put a fucking Texas Longhorn right in your lip.
Bullshit fucking one in, too. I was like, nah.
And you put a fucking Louisiana Purchase in your goddamn lip.
For some reason, I didn't know how to do it. Like, I knew it went in your lip, but my dad always, like, put it in his lip and like packed it with his tongue to the corner. And
your dad's a lizard?
My dad's fucking insane when it comes to dipping. He could probably put a dip in like upside down with his hands crossed like behind his back. But I put one in and I, for some reason, it got all over my tongue and it tasted awful. And it ruins wintergreen, like flavoring of anything like candy or anything like that. It ruined it for me. I go back in. I have it in my thing. I grabbed an empty water bottle because, you know, I was going to spit or whatever.
I was going to come in it.
Yeah. And I was going to. Yeah. You know, I like to see the mixture. And I was sitting there playing probably Call of Duty because I was 14-year-old, probably saying racial slurs. And I was sitting there, and as 14-year-olds, all of a sudden, dude, my fucking vision goes like, and I'm like, oh, and I get all nauseous, dude. And I'm like, oh boy. And immediately fucking and throw it at my trash can, run to the bathroom and hurl, dude, hurled. I threw up so much. And then I just, I'm pretty sure I went to bed. It was,
so you put a fucking,
and then I dipped after that.
You put a fucking log in the attic, Anne Frank style.
Mm-hmm. And it got caught.
Spit it out. You got caught.
It got, no, I didn't get caught. The Anne Frank got caught.
Well, but you didn't. So.
No, I didn't. That's, yeah, but I threw up, and I don't think anybody, because my dad is the same story. His coach got him hooked on it. One of his coaches was like, put it in, and then my dad was like, okay, and he put it in.
He's
and
like, can I pull my pants up first?
Put it in. What do you want? The chew. We're done with the other one.
Yeah.
And my dad said he went behind the dugout and threw up, and then he came back in, and his coach was like, put in another one.
Yeah. Now you're good.
And he's been dipping for like 35 years.
Yeah, I know. What a good role model.
It's great. I did this, and now I don't want to do it. You ever...
Oh, no. So wait. Let's go back to... So fuck people that shop at Cabela's.
I want to go back to
the Dorito.
The Dorito print.
We were going, and it blows my fucking mind. They were selling those one-chip Pocky Chip challenge. Mm-hmm. One-chip Pocky Chip challenges. Just at the store.
I thought that's like, the only place you get them was the gas station.
No, fuck that. I didn't think... Well, apparently, like, I thought you had to order them online and, like, consent to being... Dude, they're dangerous as fuck.
Yeah,
I don't
I'm sure
care.
Yeah, no way
do
a dog
not
gets,
care.
A, gets a hold of that, they're dead.
Dude, like, it is debit. I did it twice. Yes, they're insane. And then I was like, and then we were trying to get him to eat. My friend who's never done, I've done it. I almost had a fucking meltdown, dude. I don't do good with fucking mild sauce from Buffalo Wild Wings, let alone this fucking,
either.
Like, piece of shit chip. And he's like, dude, we should, like, get this. And our buddy name's Dean. We should get this and, you know, try to get Dean to eat it and prank him. And I'm like, that's like legitimately dangerous.
Was it Dev's idea?
He wanted to do it, but I was going to be like, let's just talk him into
eating it. That's a genius idea.
Like, let's buy it, bring it out, because we were going to go on the boat, and there was about to be like four of us, five of us.
You would probably do it if you just gave it to
him. That's like what I was saying. I was like, let's just like buy it and as a community trip and be like, yo, let's fucking, let's.
It's like ass. It's like,
yeah,
let's all do it together.
Let's take LSD and fucking eat this chip. And he's like, no, I think we should, like, prank him. And I'm like, dude, this is, like, a devastating fucking chip. I don't know if that's a good idea.
This ruins your day and
like,
the day
dude,
after.
It really does. Like, your asshole fucking begs you for mercy, dude. And you're fucking, oh. And but I was like, okay, I'll do it. And we just grabbed a bag of Doritos and, like, broke off, like, a hunky, because it was a huge chip, broke off, like, a healthy hunk of it and put it in there. And he wasn't eating it because we had Cool Ranch Doritos on the boat, too. And everybody likes Cool Ranch Doritos.
You think you're a Cool Ranch guy over a nacho cheese?
Me?
Yeah.
I'm a spicy nacho guy.
I thought you were a spicy sweet chili.
Or that's what I meant to say. The only
vegan Dorito, by the way, if you guys didn't know that. Mm-hmm. We ate the fuck out of those when we were doing the vegan thing.
Yeah. That was a little hack. Oreos and fucking...
I'm pretty sure Oreos have lard in them.
No, I don't think so. I'm pretty sure Oreos are vegan.
Really?
Yeah.
Or they weren't, and we just ate a bunch of them.
Or we were never vegan, ever. And
the Doritos couldn't be. That's totally off of I heard it once basis.
No, I know. I confirm that. That's why I was eating them all the time.
Those are great.
Coincidence? I don't think so.
Those are great.
And so we put that fucking Dorito in the fucking bag, and then we're on it. And then he wasn't eating it. And then I was like, all right, fuck it. I pull it out, and I'm like, whoa, look at this burnt Dorito. What the fuck?
Oh, and then, the acting skills came out on
you. Yes, dude,
nice.
And I kill it because I'm an actor. I belong in Hollywood. And then I was like, Dean, try this. Like, you try it. And I'm like, hey, fuck you and your family. You know, you piece of shit. You try it.
You try it just be, and you forget.
Yeah.
Like, I'll try it. Fine. I'm not a pussy.
And then, dude, he puts it in and then, holy fuck. And I had tears in my eyes. He was, like I said,
the boat.
Devastated. He was. It was terrible, dude. He couldn't see. He's like, he fucking drank like a 16-ounce Red Bull.
So I'm chugging beer in the TikTok.
Yeah, dude, it was insane.
It doesn't help, his mouth, like, by the way. My tongue's I've eaten the chip challenge, but I've eaten like the hot shit from like, I've dipped the Blazin and immediately was like, this is just terrible.
Fuck that, dude. They serve that shit to the public. This is like.
Anything. They serve that to the public. You don't have to be like 18 to buy it.
I'm what? Saying that's like, on the, that's like on the fucking like
you
on the 18 fucking
to buy that chip?
You might be. I don't know that. I don't. It's that fucking dangerous. More if a dangerous fucking little kid fucking went alcohol. In there. If a little kid went in there and bought that chip just to like.
He saw it on TikTok.
Just to meet fucking God. Dude. I can't believe that thing. And then so he's pissed off. He's like, we're not getting off this fucking boat until like you guys eat it. And then we both took a little bite of the corner.
You did?
And I was like, I'll take a little.
Did it again, dude. Yes, dude, you told me that you'd never do it
I did a full-ass chip, and all I did was take a nibble off the corner, and I was just fucking fucked up, dude. You wouldn't believe it. Everyone thought I was, like, making it up. I said, dude, I'm
Does anyone? I'm was anybody on the boat that took a little chip and then was like,
Devin took a little bite, and he thought it was really hot, but he didn't drink anything, and he kind of like got over it pretty quick. Where I was
that's
like,
nice.
I literally cried.
People
like
can handle spice; it's almost like a superpower.
Yeah,
to me.
I swear to God,
it's crazy.
Some people can just fucking do that.
But there's some people that are like, it's not hot, and then they're like shaking and then crying, and then say it's hot, but then the amount of time it takes you to get over it, if it's like small, I'm
it
like,
feels like
right.
forever.
I feel yeah,
like, it's like this is forever.
It's like smoking pot or something. It feels like it's gonna be forever, and time slows down.
I think the best prank. Of my life.
That wasn't the best prank of your life?
No, that
was pretty
good
fucking good.
That was a good one.
Yeah, it was.
One time, my buddy, Darren Juffer, we had a friend.
You got a lot of friends with the same name, kind of.
My friend's name was Bobby. How do I make a fake name? My friend, Jobby, was sitting on my
friend Dobby from Lord of the Rings.
Yeah.
Harry Potter,
you stoop.
Sorry, I didn't watch Lord of the Rings.
She was laying on the bed, and she was, like, sleeping, and we're all hanging out. You know, she, like, fanned out over this bed. No one else could sit anywhere.
Oh, so she sleeps like Michaela. Good.
Yeah, no, she was being an asshole, taking up the bed, and we were like, this fucking bitch. We're whispering. We're doing the
Facebook.
Were
you guys all about
we're doing the
were
Facebook
you guys all
thing.
Sharing the bed or something?
Well, we're chilling in his room, and we're, like, gonna fucking. It was, like, a midday nap or whatever. And we're, like, whispering, like, this fucking bitch, take it up the fucking bed. I'm going to kill her. I'm going to choke her out and kill her. And then we came up with a fucking awesome idea that Karen Duffer would fart in her face, wake her up. So this is how it went. Aaron fucking was locked and loaded. He's like, oh, all right, like, I'm ready. Let's do it.
That's got to be a really good, a perfectly timed prank. Is any fart or poop prank?
Dude, farts are funny. And that kid, that person, that dog, I don't know how to protect his identity. He could fart constantly. It was insane. He made me crack up in school. We would all look at him from across the class. We'd be like, do it. And he would just fucking do it. And it was hilarious. The teacher would be like, who was that? Anyway, so he rips right in her face. She wakes up and chases him out of the fucking room. And then while she was gone out of the room, we loaded up our buddy Ferret, loaded up his hand with whipped cream, loaded up his hand with shaving cream, and then she came back in and he like clapped her face with all this whipped cream. And
Christ,
and it
sounds like a fucking.
She cried and went home. It didn't end up as funny as we thought it was. She
funny,
legitimately
huh?
cried and went home, and we were like, oh, it was a fucking prank. Quit crying. But it was pretty devastating, I guess. I guess it gave her a complex because we were all still developing as people.
There's definitely steps in that prank. If you can pull out steps.
Yeah.
That's nice. I used to date this girl that would pull this prank on me all the time.
No, you didn't. Go ahead.
And it was a long time ago, like middle school. She would like text me on like, I had like my fucking NV5 or whatever the hell I had with the fucking keyboard. She used to text me and like, I wanted to break up with her, and then she said she was going to kill herself. I always thought that was a nice prank.
Mm-hmm.
That's it. She never did it.
Wait.
Did you just say, yeah, if you break up with me, I'm going to kill myself?
It's quite the segue you had there.
Yep. That's my. I thought that was a fun prank. Now that I look at it, she didn't mean it. It was all fun. They were probably laughing at it. Her and her friends. Watch this fucking asshole.
She's not here anymore, but.
Yeah, sadly. She passed away. She got mauled by a bear.
Oh, my God.
The bear didn't think it was funny, and he fucking went to her house and beat the shit out of her with his bear paws.
I feel like we got to wake up. Are you tired?
No, I'm really nervous.
Nervous?
Yeah, I got to travel for this job. And
why is that? No, that's nothing to be nervous about.
Just like, get, you know, like,
that's dumb. I'm going to take your feelings and I'm going to
you know, like,
tell
getting
them that
there,
they're dumb.
You know, like, first of all, starting a new job is always fucking scary. I know you haven't fucking had to work for anybody in a long time. New. Like, the last, like, job you had was.
When I was slow, I would go pick up hours at road construction.
Yeah, but you knew those guys. Like, going into a new environment is fucking scary. And, like, everybody's, like, thinks they're fucking.
Everybody, no.
Who's a new guy? Fucking new guy?
You work for Geek Squad. Everyone's a fucking virgin, dude. That goes to fucking Comic-Con. And has Star Trek fucking shirts.
Yeah. But no. No.
That's really kind of old.
I mean, I'm a geek, dude, if it's anything. I think that name kind of makes it. That name takes away from a lot. The stuff that they do is pretty fucking crazy.
They're geeks. Yeah, they can do a lot.
They're fucking nuts. I traveled an hour and a half to switch this guy's microwave time from military time to regular time. I pressed 5 buttons and then I left and had to drive all the way back.
No, you didn't.
I promise. It was in Mount
Pleasant.
Man,
people don't have like family members or something.
I was like, dude,
crazy.
I was like, do you have the manual? He's like, no. And I understand, like, no one keeps the manuals, but keep the manual. Just keep it in the box somewhere. I pull up the manual, the like online manual. I just looked up the serial number and gave me a manual. And I was like, beep, beep, beep. And he's like, how the fuck did you do that? And I was like,
you're like, that's my job, sir. Geek Squad out.
Course,
and then you
fucking
did a bunch of turns and threw a smoke bomb at the ground.
It's just about, you saw me doing it. I was going to smoke. I pulled my cape
throw
over.
Threw a smoke bomb out, and then the smoke cleared, and then you saw you walking out and tripping.
Saw me running away. Forgot my tools. I left them all there.
No givesies, backsies.
he was like, and then he's like, can you explain the steps that you did? I was like, I pressed the settings button on the microwave, and then it said it had a clock. And then I pressed the clock button.
He had to have paid $80 to $180 for
He
that.
Has a membership, which is like
a
$100
Geek
a year.
Membership?
Yeah, so like anything you buy from Best Buy, we come out and diagnose it for free. And that comes in the...
Do you and your fellow geeks call it diag?
I'm the only one in the area that does repairs. Now. So I'm the only one that has to deal with that bullshit. Going out there and like beep, 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 and then done. And that's half my day, which is kind of cool. It's not my car, but yeah, going to like Grand Rapids and Cleveland is where I'm going the next 2 weeks, and which sucks because Cleveland's the worst city ever.
I thought you said Chicago.
They changed it because they know the people in Cleveland better. I don't know. They.
I quit.
I know. I was like, well, I'm done. They're giving me like a per diem and putting me up in a pretty nice hotel, which I can't. Back to my biggest fear, dude. I don't like being alone. I'm going to sit there and like start doing drugs or something.
Masturbate.
Well, yeah, obviously. I'm going to definitely defile that room. I'm going to make that room.
I'm going to throw lamps at the fucking wall.
I am going to make it like, dude, you go to a hotel by yourself. It's free game, dude. You do whatever you want.
I don't think I've ever been in a hotel by myself.
Oh, dude, I went for my other job. They put me up for a training. I just fucking defiled it in the bathroom, in the hallway to the bathroom, on both beds.
In the hallway, in the public bathroom.
On both beds. Yeah, it is. The curtain's wide open, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
My ass cheeks pressed up against the glass. I love that cold glass on my ass.
Children's library across the street.
Mm-hmm. They weren't too happy about that. I was like, I'm in the adult section. What are you guys doing? Get your hands off me. Get off me.
I went to the library and I said, hey, can I have a... I went up to the librarian and said, can I have a cheeseburger with some french fries? And she was like, sir, this is a library. And I was like, oh, I'm sorry. Can I have a cheeseburger?
You suck, idiot. You're an idiot.
Thanks. All right. Wake up. Wake up exercise. Ready?
Yep.
You ever see Step Brothers?
Yep.
You know the part where they're singing in the car?
Yep.
Go ahead.
Boom. Oh, fuck.
Dumb.
Ha.
Dumb.
Ha.
Dumb. She's got a smile, it seems to me, reminds me of childhood memory. Everything was as fresh as a brand new sky.
Oh, we just lost 40 fucking listeners.
They're like, this is so loud in my car. My kid's in the car. He's crying. Because everybody has kids.
Oh,
now.
You're so ugly. You don't even look good. You don't even look good while you do it.
Bow, bow. I'm Derek, and I can sing high like that.
Now you sing high.
Is it bad that I want to fucking fuck that kid's face up?
Yeah, he kind of sucks.
Man, he's just a kid. He's just a kid acting, and I had a real life
he's
feeling.
He's like moving. I'm like, I got to turn the movie off. It was a great movie until that fucking dumb kid. I was shitting at work the other day.
Oh my god!
And I realized how fucking quiet. Like, if there's any place to fucking turn the music up,
if I have to shit in public and there's other people in there, I will always I will watch TikTok loud.
Really? I get self conscious about what's on my phone because I'm afraid it's gonna say something crazy and then I'm gonna have to explain myself.
I just for some reason don't want them to hear my.
But yeah, no,
shit,
I'm shitting.
Interrupted me.
Well, I was telling you a story.
Dude.
Okay, so I let you tell your dumb librarian joke. Let me talk. I'm shitting. I'm done. You know, I got my Poseidon's kiss from when the fucking water came and touched my asshole. I'm like, oh, that was nice. And then I grabbed their.
That's my bidet.
I grabbed their fucking McDonald's napkins that they have for fucking toilet paper. And honestly, I would like McDonald's napkins more. I can see through the fucking
I grabbed their 80 grit sandpaper.
And when you're in public shitting, you grab so much toilet paper.
Yeah, because it's one ply, and you don't want to finger your own asshole trying to fucking.
If you did that at home, you would waste. There's no way companies aren't going bankrupt for how much toilet paper they have to buy because they're pulling out so much. There's a guy in the other stall. I'm shitting in the handicap stall because I don't care. And the guys in. Hopefully a guy in the wheelchair is in the smaller stall.
Trying to figure it out.
Yeah. No maneuver. There's no bar for him. I'm using the bar to hopefully get this shit out.
He's got fucking MS and he's trying to figure out where to put those little crutches.
He can't. He's trying to hang him on the coat hanger.
He's like, I swear to God, when you come out, you better be fucking rolling. I'm waiting for you. You're like, Mark, you got to come out. You got to. You text your mom again. You got to come
out. I crawl out like a Nazi zombie that just got a grenade.
You tried to make a crawler. I swear to God, if you come out here able-bodied, I will fucking lose it.
If I see two steps,
you better not have
and
every
no limp.
You better not. If you have every limb correctly attached to your body, I will fucking lose it.
I come out with like one hand.
Yeah.
That doesn't count.
You pull your hand in your sleeve. You're like, oh man, can you help me wipe?
Anyway, that gets a good segue.
Meanwhile, he's in a
it's
fucking.
It's so quiet in there, dude, and the acoustics are so great. This guy can. I'm wiping, and I'm like, this is really loud. I'm wiping, and it's so loud. And it's like,
gross.
And the guy can hear me because, you know, I'm doing that.
Sounds like you were starting a fire.
Yeah, obviously it's not. I never take like healthy dumps. It's always like just really, really bad. And I'm wiping. I'm really getting in there because there's no, you know, why don't we have bidets? Okay. That's one thing that we didn't take from Europe. We took their land and shit. That's wrong. That's historically incorrect. But. We don't have bidets. I think they're the best thing ever. I used one once, and it was the cleanest my asshole's ever been, ever. I'm wiping like I'm trying to fucking smother a fucking forest fire. And, you know, I throw it in, and I'm like, that was so loud. And then I walk out, and I hear his shit hit the toilet. And I'm like, we shouldn't be this close. Audibly.
Public restrooms are an insane thing. It's one of those things where it's like,
oh,
you just grow up your whole life with that happening, but you think to yourself, like, this is, like, a crazy thing.
Play some music, man. I don't even care if it's fucking 102.5.
This is crazy, dude. You'd be a kid, and you'd go into, like, you're at the fucking baseball game or something. You just see a bunch of flaccid cocks in a row pissing in a fucking trough.
Yeah, and it's just, like, people are spitting in it and throwing up in it. And
oh, look at all those.
It's like,
My dad's like, well, have at it.
Go ahead. Get in there. Squeeze in there.
Get in there. Say, excuse me.
I'm done with the whole leaving a urinal open in between people, especially like when we went to see Bill Burr at the Fox Theater and when I got lost, like a little sad boy in like in a store with his mom. I had to call you. There was like no urinals open but one, and I went in there and I felt the guy, both guys next to me, like
turn.
I'm like, what, dude? There's what? You want me to wait? You want me to wait?
I wait. I don't ever have to pee that bad.
Dude, for some reason, I always have to pee. It's either I don't have to pee or it's a fucking issue.
Well, you just said how you like looking at fucking dicks yesterday on the last podcast. So.
Yeah. And what does that have to do with peeing?
Well, maybe they don't feel comfortable.
I don't. We're not that big. Not everybody knows that I like that. I haven't even, you know, I won't even preface it again because I felt so weak when I said that.
What?
I felt weak.
Why'd you feel weak?
I don't know. I curled up in a ball after you left, and then...
No, stop. I supported you. No, you support... There's nothing wrong with it.
You backhanded supported me.
No, I didn't.
You had so many off-color questions.
They were not off-color questions. They were genuine questions.
I know.
I think you need to take a...
I had a cool...
You need to take a test.
Yeah, no, I definitely need to...
I think you need to take a gay or straight test and figure yourself out.
You want to call this person?
Call this person.
So let me preface this.
It's time to
Mark
preface this.
Played a show at the Temple Theater in Saginaw last Saturday.
Doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter.
I'm lying.
You probably weren't there. And it's a good thing you weren't. No, he's mad now.
I am mad.
Don't play anything. It's hooked up. Michaela, it's the day before Thanksgiving. Oh, no, it was Wednesday. It was the day before Thanksgiving. Michaela had already gone down to her family in the worst city possible, Flint, Michigan. And I was all home alone, and, you know, I had already masturbated in every room. So then I was like, all right. So I went to the bar, and I had a drink with my dad. And then after that, I was like, well, I'm going to go to Mark's show. I don't care if I have to go alone. I want to go see his set because I'm a good friend. And,
God, get to it.
Okay. Well,
he just talked about how you had to like be home alone. Fast forward. You're at the,
I'm like, I call my friend Mia, who's the only person that actually likes to go see Mark play and is into the same music and,
getting defensive.
Yeah, I am because I felt like I have to, I was really pissed. And so I take her, we go. And we get there, we sit down, we both have drinks in our hand. Then we start talking to Chris, and then Mark comes out, start talking to Mark. And then Mark is the second band up, so we get up and go stand near the place. And then
basically, Mason was there with his friend Mia. They had friends for a long time, very platonic relationship. Somebody at the end of...
What does platonic mean? I'm worried you don't know what that means, and I don't know what it means.
I'm pretty sure platonic means, like, there's no feelings attached.
Zero.
I thought. I'm pretty sure platonic.
We've been friends since we could, you know, walk.
So they were hanging out, plate tectonics, and...
Yeah, we were getting... We were earthquakes, and we're up front. And... The only time I ever touched her the whole night, because I FaceTimed her afterwards, I was like, did we do anything? So here's where I'm going to come in.
Only time I touched her was she said a funny joke, and I smacked her ass and said, good one.
And I ripped, you know.
And then I kissed her. But I don't see how that could be possibly misconstrued.
So Michaela gets a text message, and I don't put this anywhere past her. It was very, she got anxious, and I understand that because getting a text like that sucks.
We both, because Mason called me and asked everything about it, we have both confirmed Michaela's feelings and standpoint on
very
this.
Much.
It was very valid. It was very valid. And
so this text message,
we do stand Michaela.
This text message reads, okay, it reads, let me pull it up. Fuck you, Apple. Fuck you, and everything you stand for. Jesus Christ.
This is Mark filling up the time with a funny joke. Hey, guys.
Cool. I deleted it because I didn't want to to fucking look at it any longer.
I'm sure you don't even have the number.
I'm sure Michaela has it. Yeah.
So you don't have the number?
Well, I can grab Michaela's phone.
It's gonna take too long.
So the text message basically were like, "Hey, I'm at a concert in Saginaw. Barely a concert, by the way. I'm at a show in Saginaw, and I think your boyfriend's here with another girl." And that was the first text. And Michaela said, "Who is this?" And or Michaela said, like, "Oh yeah, they're there. It's his friend, and they're there to see their friend play in a band for a screen." And then the other person said, "Had to have been a girl, because there's no way a dude does this." Because girls just love to just fucking put the fucking...
It's just never fucking enough.
You just put a spoon in the bowl and stir it, is what they like to do. And they... So...
They see milk and they just want to tip it over.
The next one says, like, "Well, it kind of looks like they're more than friends, so I just wanted to... I didn't feel right not to tell you." And Michaela again said, "Who is this, man? Who is saying this? Who knows me? Who has my number? Who has Michaela's number? Who knows Mason? And who doesn't know that Mason is friends with a friend that he's been friends with for 20 years, dude? 20 fucking years. Maybe a little less than that. Maybe 15 years. And so she calls me. She's panicking, kind of. And I was like, "I was there with Mia. You can test. I can testify to that. And so can Mark. I was there. We were basically talking to him the entire night, except for when he wasn't on stage. And then when he wasn't on stage anymore, we were backstage with him."
We weren't with Mark, of course. We were just backstage in a closet.
Fingering.
But no.
And so, and then they didn't respond. And I think that's a fucking coward move, by the way. And I knew they wanted, or I was like, "Should I say it on the podcast? Do they want that? Do they listen?" And they're sitting there,
they don't give a fuck,
fingering themselves to this. And I'm like, you know what? Fuck it. That's a coward move. And you're a pussy, by the way. You're a pussy for trying to fucking put your little dumb finger.
What? Okay, hold on.
Okay, you're I'm going nuts.
Go nuts. Go crazy.
You're putting your finger in somebody else's relationship and you're trying to fuck it up just because you're sad your dad fucking left you and you got issues, okay? You got issues that some fucking guy on Tinder can't fucking resolve with his 3-inch fucking cock going in and out of you for 30 seconds. Mm. He blows all over your tits, doesn't even help you clean it up, he leaves.
Mm.
Fuck you, okay? That sucks. You suck and you're a coward. I hope you fucking get some sort of disease that kills you, okay? That kills you. I hope you get stabbed with a knife. Go ahead.
And I don't think that's unfair. I think
I hope you get stabbed. You fall on a gun and it goes off in your brain, okay? Fuck you. And if it was a guy, if it was somebody I know and it was a joke, that's fucking hilarious, okay?
Thank you very much for that. That hilarious. Was the best prank of my life.
Because it ruined me for a night.
And we thank you.
So me and
so
Mia,
it depends who it is. It could either be the best thing to ever happen, or you should find a
flashback,
bridge.
Flashback. Me and Mia were trying to think of what the fuck did we do that made it look so much like we were not more than friends. And I was thinking, I was like, I touched you one time for about 2 seconds.
You touched her for a full 2 seconds.
Full 2 seconds without her panicking.
Uh-oh.
And so there was these couple girls, one in a wheelchair, and I know you know this, one in a wheelchair and one in a walker, and they were young, and they were moving up to the front of the stage, which is a bad place to be if you're crippled. So she runs over my fucking foot, okay? She runs over my foot, and she goes, "Oh, sorry," and I'm like, and I lean over because she ruined my fucking toes, okay?
Ruined like, "Oh, them. Great. Now I can't even walk."
Yeah. I said, "Great. Now I can't even fucking walk. Can I borrow your walker?" Fuck, dude. You almost... And so I put my hand on her back, and I go, "Oh." And then I say to Mia, "Sorry." And she's like, "No, she ran over your foot." I was like, "Yeah, kind of." And then that was it.
So I put my hand on Mia's butt for stability.
I put my hand on her naked ass for 5 seconds.
Just to keep myself from falling over.
That was that. And you know what? I'm sorry I said cripple, but I don't think that's unfair. Because if you have a disability, you don't go in the front row of a rock show.
Why
okay?
not? They're not going to see it from the back.
That's fair, but maybe that's not your side stage. There was plenty of room on the side.
What if they didn't feel comfortable being side stage?
But
some
they
people
felt,
aren't allowed
but
to
they
be
felt
side
more
stage.
Comfortable
Well, yeah.
If anything, they would be allowed side stage.
No, it's a public show, and they're people like everybody else, so they get to do what they want to do, and they were escorted to the front where they could enjoy the show.
Maybe they should have been escorted better because they ruined my day.
I can't back
it. It was probably her that did it. It's probably that lady that run over my toe. She probably texted him.
She heard you bitching, and then she was all salty.
Yeah. I didn't know. That was my night. And then I didn't want Michaela to feel like she couldn't, like, trust me anymore. And then I called you. I was panicking. You were at a bar. And I couldn't hear you. And I was like, great. Tell me something. Walk me through. Okay, you're tired, right?
Yeah.
Walk me through a day in the life of Mark. What did you do? What did you do today?
Really?
I had the day off today. I worked yesterday. I had the day off today. I had to leave for work tomorrow. What did you do today? Starting from the beginning.
I woke up.
Okay.
7:30, dusk. Or dawn. I don't know what the difference between either of them.
Dawn.
And I woke up at dusk 30 and sun peeking through my window. Rays tickling my closed eyes.
Jesus Christ.
Lightly, I opened them.
I opened a can. I didn't want to eat it.
I always wake up. I pat on my chest like this. Rambo always comes on bed and he lays down with me. I snuggle him, tell him I love him, tell him he was a good boy. I say, who's a good boy? He's a good boy. Woke up, went and played hockey.
You played hockey?
Went and had band practice.
You played hockey today?
Yeah, went and dropped in.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Why didn't you call me?
Should I have?
Yeah, I was up at fucking 7.
That was the first time I played in 3 years, dude. My fucking chest felt like it was about to fucking cave in.
Well, that's cool. You want to start playing again?
I don't know. I kind of didn't love it out there. I was like, I'm all right with never playing ever again.
Well, yeah, that's going to happen when you haven't fucking done physical things.
Almost tipped over everything in the studio.
In a year.
And,
Oh, you call it the studio.
That's what you call this. And then went to band practice, went home, started gutting out my house more.
You should have called me.
Why? Do you want to help me gut out my house?
I told you I'd help you.
Fucking roommate won't even help me. He's supposed to be over.
But
I knew he wouldn't come over unless I had to, like,
beg him. If there's one thing I can do, it's fucking be there. You know? I'm always there if I'm saying I'm there. Except for that one time.
Yeah.
But
that one time sucked.
Oh, that one time I saw a lady get fucked.
I didn't care
by
about
a car.
That.
So anyway,
you called me and you were like, I can't make it. Like, I just watched a bad car accident and I did not care about it. I said, I don't
know. I know
you
didn't.
I did. I don't care if you're the only one to see it. I don't care if you accidentally hit a fucking pedestrian on a bike. Come here, help me, and then go back if there's time. And I couldn't be mad at you about it, but I was fucking furious about it.
Yeah, that was a bad day.
Yeah, you call me and you're like, hey, dude, I can't make it over there today. Like, I just had a car accident.
And you know what?
I just watched a car accident happen. I got to stay. And I'm like, oh, yeah, you're just a big fucking hero, aren't you, Mason? Oh, yeah, Mason making the fucking day better. Hope you get a fucking award. No one gives a fuck about you except me. Get over to this fucking job and help me finish it before I fucking kill everybody. Before there's 30 car accidents and they're all your fault.
Nobody cares about any of us. I don't even, you know, and what were we talking about? Oh, yeah, go ahead.
That's it. Now I'm here.
That's what you did all day?
Yeah.
It's called work. Okay, one, I'm mad because, one, I would have loved to come play hockey. Two, I would have loved to come fucking help you with your house. And three, there's no three.
Three.
But, you just don't want to hang out with me. You think this is too much? Is this too much? Is this too much me for you?
No.
Too much me for you?
No, I told you.
Good album cover title?
Too much me for you?
Too much me for you.
I'll let you have that one.
All right.
You go ahead and keep that one.
I'll keep it in the notebook.
No, I told you. These podcast episodes take energy. They take good moods to have fun ideas. This is easily our worst episode. And I'm all tired.
No, our worst episode is not out there.
Oh, because we deleted it? We were like, oh, man.
Our
we
best
should delete this one.
Our best episode is also not out there.
That sucked. That was a kick in the fucking
But,
nuts.
You know, we keep going. No, that was a good one. We got 10 minutes.
You made fun of disabled people.
That's all in good fun.
Arguably.
You had two people in the fucking front row obvious disabilities, and you sang your lyrics verbatim were, I need a blizzard to freeze over my hell, crutches to help move my feet.
It's relatable.
They can't use crutches, my man.
Why not?
They need chairs with wheels. If you want to change up the lyrics for them, go ahead.
Well, I wasn't staring at anyone in the
eyes. I need a blizzard to freeze over my hell. One of those automatic fucking things that go to get in your...
An amigo from Walmart.
No, yeah, no, they... I don't take back that I said cripple, but, you know, I mean, I don't
You could
mean
say cripple isn't...
You looked at me weird.
Because you said they weren't allowed to be, like, at their show.
I didn't say they weren't allowed to be at the show.
I just said you needed to be in the back where you can't...
You did rebuttal very well. They can't see from the back.
That's like black people sitting at the front of the bus, and you're like, what are you doing here?
Gay. I thought we went over this.
You're like, what's going on?
Parks is dead.
I don't care that you're... I don't care you're on the bus. Just get out of the way. You know what I mean? Yeah, keep smoking your stupid fucking USB fucking...
Man, I'm stressed, okay? We all have to deal with stress in the same way.
Jesus Christ.
You staying for dinner?
No.
Why?
Because you guys made a fucking chicken breast to split between the two of you with some mashed potatoes. There's not enough. There's not enough.
Me and Michaela always like to think that you're that really, really sad, poor...
I am.
What the dumb fuck? Friend. And we always take you in. You know, you don't have anywhere to go for Christmas.
I don't.
And we buy you gifts. I bought you a Christmas gift.
You didn't, because I'm not going to take it. Mark Duhame doesn't take a fucking handout. He doesn't take gifts. He doesn't take money. He doesn't take help.
Well, I think half of those are the reason why you're poor. He doesn't take money or handouts.
I sing or goddamn swim. I don't want your presence. I am fucking Ebenezer Scrooge.
You took Michaela's Bill Burr ticket like it was fucking a food kitchen. You're like, damn it.
Her tits were broke. What the fuck was she going to do with them?
They were fixed, if anything.
Is it Ebenezer Scrooge, right? Or is it
Ebenezer Scrooge, yeah.
Herbal tea.
Oscar Mayer?
Herbal tea Scrooge.
What are you doing, man?
Come on.
Man,
can we wrap this fucking episode up? Oh my god, can this episode be fucking over?
That was beautiful.
Hey, we didn't get a single fucking email.
Yeah, what's up
you
with
know
that?
Why this episode sucks? We didn't have a fucking email to riff off.
No,
of.
Go off on them. This is
that's bullshit.
This is your report card. This if is parent teacher conferences, and we're about to fucking tell your
not
parents.
Not to break the fourth wall.
Okay.
But I'm talking to the listener directly right now.
I think you should.
Everyone has a question. Everyone has a story. Everyone has an opinion.
That they don't want to say themselves. We'll say it for you.
Make a fucking anonymous email. All right? It's not that hard. Is there a way you can email anonymously?
No, but we won't
can
say
you star 67?
We won't say your name. I made that.
I have beg and plead Mason to stop saying names.
I won't. Yeah,
show,
no, I'm getting better. I'm getting better.
He will not.
I'm getting better. I didn't say. You said Dean's name. I didn't say Dean when I was talking about
I can do
about
that, but if people are emailing and yeah, no, saying like, hey, I have.
I won't say their name. I won't say your name. And if I make the mistake, I'll bleep it out. But
yeah, and you people can't email and be like, I got this weird sore on my balls and I don't know what I should. You can't just be like, oh, Greg from 34th Street at fucking. Can't do that.
No. I won't do that. I won't do that. I'm sorry.
Send us an email. Make it up. I don't care.
December 11th.
rockbottompodcast69@gmail.com. rockbottompodcast69@gmail.com.
It's all over my social media. Mark doesn't care about this, so it's not on his. So December 11th. Mark, what you got going on?
Creed cover show.
Creed cover show. You excited?
Yes.
You are excited.
Yeah.
I would be excited too. Mark did Mark did
Forza 5.
Mark did Foo Fighters 2 years ago before the pandemic, and it was a really fun show.
Yeah, it was before the Piranha came.
It's at the Crown Pub. It's put on by Excellency in Bay City. It's December 11th. It's a Saturday. Second Saturday of December. There's like six or seven bands.
There's a band covering Blink-182.
All American Rejects.
I don't ever want to hear Blink-182 ever again, but I'll watch that for one last time. All American Rejects.
Aerosmith.
Heart.
Heart was cool.
I never really cared until I met you. I hope this Heart cover set fucking goes, because I will be front row fucking.
What was the last one? I had it pulled up.
Don't look. Beatles.
Yeah, that sucks.
Who cares? No, it'll be great.
They have so many songs, though. How do you pick?
I know. You just have to play Blackbird like 6 times.
I like Blackbird. So, yeah. Go out and support the local music scene if you're around here. If you're around the old Bay City area.
Bay City Mish.
Support that. It's a fun time. Get some drinks. Get really wasted. Make a fool of yourself. Get kicked out. I don't care. What you do. Okay, just what listen do? To the band.
Drive home for all I fucking care.
Yeah, who cares? Like, risk it. Risk it for the biscuit, man.
Yeah, roll the dice. Again, email us, rockbottompodcast69@gmail.com.
With anything. Anything, dude. Preferably picture your butt. But your balloon knot. I want to see your asshole.
Jesus.
But, well, in recap, I can't go out with my friends anymore. Because apparently I just fuck all of them.
Mason gets exposed.
Yeah. To random people.
I don't know how everyone keeps getting Michaela's number.
Did we actually put it in a podcast episode?
I really don't think so.
I think we said like at the first couple letters and then the beep boops. Maybe there's some fucking hacker out there that's like, I got it.
Fuck your life. Bing bong.
Byron.
Hey, who's the president? Byron. You ever see that TikTok?
No.
I'm ending this fucking podcast. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you. Have a good one.
Oh, no.
Have a good one, everybody. We'll see you next week.
First time ever the other night, I had sleep paralysis, and I felt like Stephen Hawking, and I thought, well, this is awful. I don't ever want to do this again.